Assalamu alaikum. This is SRM from Thais Schooling, and today we are going to talk about the arterial supply of the stomach. Now, as we know that the abdominal aorta arises at the T12, and when the descending aorta passes from the diaphragm, then its name changes and it is called the abdominal aorta. It arises at the level of T12. Now the stomach is mainly supplied by the one of the branches of the abdominal aorta, which is called the celiac artery, But abdominal aorta has other two main branches, which is one of them is superior mesenteric artery and other is inferior mesenteric artery. Now, as we know that the celiac artery arises at the upper border of the L1, and the superior mesenteric artery arises at the lower border of the L1, and the inferior mesenteric artery arises at the level of L3. Okay, so we are not going to talk about the superior mesenteric artery and the inferior mesenteric artery, because these arteries not supply the stomach. We have to talk about only the celiac artery, which is the main supply, which is the main source of supply of the stomach. Now, celiac artery has three main branches. As we know that celiac artery arises at the level of L1, and it gives one branch, the first branch, which is called the left gastric artery, Now the left gastric artery supplies the left border of the stomach. As well as the left gastric artery also supply the esophagus. The part of the esophagus below the diaphragm is supplied by the left gastric artery. Here the left gastric artery gives some branches, which is called the esophageal branches, and these branches supply the abdominal part of the esophagus. So we have talking about the first branch of the celiac artery, which supply the left upper border of the stomach. Now there is another artery which is called the hepatic artery. This is the second branch of the celiac artery, the hepatic artery. This hepatic artery gives a branch which is called the right gastric artery. You can see that. And this right gastric artery supply the left lower border of the stomach. And this right gastric artery anastomoses with the left gastric artery, which arises from the celiac artery. And these both arteries anastomosis with each other. Now hepatic artery also give another branch which goes posteriorly to the stomach. This dotted line shows that this artery is going to the posterior of the stomach, and this artery is known as gastroduodenal artery. And this gastroduodenal artery gives two branches. One is the right gastric epipolaic artery, and the other branch is called superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. The superior pancreaticoduodenal artery goes downward, and where it goes we will talk about later, but the one branch, which is called the right gastroepipolaic artery, this supply the greater curvature, the right side of the greater curvature of the stomach. Okay, so we have talking about the two main branches of the celiac artery, and the celiac artery, we know that it is the main branch of the abdominal aorta, right? So we have talking about the two branches of the celiac arteries. And now another branch from the celiac artery, which arises at the same level and goes posteriorly to the stomach. This dotted line is showing you that this goes posterior to the stomach, and this goes on the head, on the superior side of the head of the pancreas and the body of the pancreas. And here is your spleen, and it goes towards the spleen. That's why we call it splenic artery. And when it goes to the spleen, it gives some branches which supply the stomach. And there are two branches which supply the stomach. The first branch, is called the short gastric arteries. There are many branches. The short gastric arteries which supply the fundus of the stomach. The short gastric artery supply the fundus of the stomach. Right? Good. Now there is another branch which is called the left epipolaic artery. The left epipolaic artery. Remember one thing. The right gastroepipolaic artery is the branch of the gastroduodenal artery, and the gastroduodenal artery is the branch of the hepatic artery, and the left gastroepipolaic artery is the branch of the splenic artery, and we know that splenic artery is the main branch of the celiac artery, right? Good. So this left gastroepipolaic artery, you can see here, the left gastroepipolaic artery anastomosis with the right gastroepipolaic artery. And this left gastroepipolaic artery gives some branches which supply to the greater curvature, the left part of the greater curvature. And all these arteries, we can see that all these arteries anastomosis anteriorly and posteriorly with each other. Remember one thing, the splenic artery not directly supply to the stomach, it just goes behind the stomach and then it gives some branches as the short gastric artery and the left gastroepipolaic arteries, and these arteries supply the stomach. So this is all about the stomach, this is all about the arterial supply of the stomach. Let's summarize the topic which we have learned today. Okay. As we know that the abdominal aorta gives three branches, the celiac artery, the superior mesenteric artery and the inferior mesenteric artery. The celiac artery at the upper border of the L1 and superior mesenteric artery at the lower border of the L1 and the inferior mesenteric artery at L3. And now celiac artery is the main branch, as I told you, it supplies the stomach. Celiac artery gives three branches, the left gastroduodenal artery which supplies the left curvature of the stomach, and the hepatic arteries, and the hepatic arteries give two branches, right gastric artery, gastroduodenal artery, and the gastroduodenal artery give two branches, right gastroepipolaic artery and superior pancreaticoduodenal arteries, and this branch supplies the stomach. And the splenic artery gives two branches, short gastric artery and the left gastroepipolaic artery. And these, I have told you, these supply the stomach. Okay, keep visiting Thai Schooling for more videos. Thank you very much.